good surround on these tanks from Beastie Cutie. Clyde breaking out of that stranglehold. The tank count now 12-13, and once again we have an even game.
Yeah, and exactly. Now Clyde has the slight unit advantage yet again. So, I mean, this is Marine Tank for you. This is pretty typical Marine Tank. It does go back and forth quite a bit. Oh, Terran player is feeling so confident with this matchup, but it's so crazy. Clyde, oh, huge tank volleys. But does he have enough?
This is the only matchup in StarCraft where I can legitimately compare it to a game of chess. TVT, especially in Marine Tank Viking, really is just that much on a knife edge. You are positioning your units very carefully on the map. You're taking your time, moving slowly, making sure where your opponent is at all times, double checking every single move you do, and one wrong move could cost you the game.
You really have to use a lot of scans with this matchup as well, like we're seeing Clyde unsieging for just a second to move slightly over. Those unsieges tempt your opponent to try to run in and defeat you, which doesn't work too well if you immediately siege up again. So you see a lot of Terran players doing these fake unsieges and then just little scoots over to the left or right. Yep, see Clyde just unsieging again for a second.
Oh my goodness, we have Beastie Cutie expanding over here to the top. However, there is a Marine underneath that orbital command, and a small squad of Marines actually is going to head over before the orbital can land. I think this orbital will go down as well.
It certainly might. That CC getting very, very low, down to 300 hit points, 200, 100, and Clyde gets it.
And there's the hairdryer, Doa.
Yep, at the same time, Clyde moving in as well, taking out more tanks. Clyde may have found a way to come back and win this game.
Oh, he needs to be a bit careful. Beastie now sieging up, but he has actually been moved back a little. He's sieging up on the low ground, which means the high ground in the middle is actually no man's land at the moment. How many times do we say that? We're used to people positioning themselves on the high ground and shooting down, but it looks like Beastie actually getting a couple of tanks going out of position, but there are way too many tanks from Clyde, and Clyde definitely takes the high ground here on the north side of the map. A lot of medevacs here from Clyde as well, but not that many Marines.
The supply is so even. I mean, right now this push from Clyde is in order to help him get his fifth base up and running. He's not interested in pushing ahead and trying to kill off BCQD, trying to kill his fourth base. He just wants his fifth to survive. Nice drop on those tanks. One does go down. But Clyde returning fire and killing some more units of BCQD's. Dead even on supply right now. What a back and forth TVT. This is crazy.
We have got Clyde taking this base off to the left, though, and that could prove pivotal in the longer term because he is going to be able to mine more. We'll have to wait and see, but we do have a counterattack coming in against the fourth base here. There is a tank in the mineral line, but there are three tanks here on the high ground from Beastie Cutie. That tank goes down very, very quickly indeed. Now the planetary fortress is under siege. What is the mineral situation looking like? Because of this, Beastie Cutie is now actually mining double the minerals that Slayer's Clyde is mining, and this might be the battle we were looking for all game long. Clyde gonna be stimming in, and look at the tags melting like hotcakes here. BC getting caught out of position a bit with the tags on the high ground. There are still two more on the low ground, though.
Clyde, I think, overextending just a little bit there, losing a few more Marines than he really needed to. He did lose his fourth base as well. He couldn't really bring units back to defend it. He now needs to defend his fifth base, which is now his fourth again.
Oh no, and the third actually lifted up from Clyde as well. These guys denying each other mining. I have a feeling, though, that Beastie Cutie is doing the better job at the moment because he has been able to mine uninterrupted from this fourth base all game long, and Clyde is just having to position himself here, there, and everywhere.
Yeah, Clyde just continuing to be aggressive. He knows he needs to do some damage, deny his opponent that economy somehow because he's lost so much. He still hasn't started mining again at his third. Now the SCV is just finally coming back here.
And it looks like no mining now, Doa, for Clyde. Clyde is not mining. He only has this base over here on the left. Oh, no. Okay, good. The SCV's now right-clicked on those minerals. They were idle for the longest time.
Yeah.
And finally, he's mining it, but BCQD definitely taking a big lead now. Oh,
Clyde looking
drops.
A bit nervous. I mean, the thing is, BCQD, after killing those bases, he really knows that he can kind of win the war of attrition now. You know, he can use Marines and medevacs to trim down the tank count and eventually get to that point where he can try to overrun Clyde. The game's not over yet, but things certainly looking good for our Empire Terran player right now.
Oh, wow, and auto turrets going down at the third as well. We all know how long those last, Doa.
Quite a while.
They are going to be sieging up the third base here of Clyde, and that in turn means that Beastie Cutie, oh, he is just an absolute boss at the moment. Now going to be taking this base as well. There's a single Marine here. We have Mortal Kombat with a whole bunch of drones. Wow, upgraded Marines are really good. 3-3, killing about 5 or 6 drones before they actually come out. That was quite incredible there, but fortunately, both players now able to expand once more. The difference is Beastie Cutie is on one additional base.
Yep, that's right. And so that's something that he can continue to kind of press to his advantage, right? He's going to have the ability to do kind of what we're seeing here near his fourth base, where he can send out smaller groups of units to harass Clyde's outlying bases. And Clyde really can't move away from his position that he has outside of the fourth of BC Cutie, because that's going to then leave his base vulnerable, allow BC Cutie to feel a little bit less pressure. So Clyde kind of caught between a rock and a hard place right now in this game.
And the other thing that Beastie Cutie has been doing this game, whenever Clyde comes forward with a small number of units to attack Beastie Cutie, mm-hmm. Beastie Cutie's been cleaning it up. He's been going over to the third base location, making sure all those units are gone before pushing out. But if we take a look, this clump of units over here that attacked the fourth base earlier on, they're still alive, and Clyde has to keep that in mind. In the back of his head, he needs to make sure that he doesn't get too complacent and allow these units room to breathe.
Well, that's
so there are a couple of siege tanks here, and they're going to be able to defend this newest base as well.
That's right. Now the Marines do run into position of the siege tank, so Clyde does have to pull back. I mean, yeah, BC Cutie just has enough army right now. He's ahead enough supply that he can just camp out little squads of units outside of Clyde's bases. He's got one outside that old fourth base. He's got his little amount protecting his fourth base as well. That's going to be tough for Clyde from this point on.
Clyde has a good spread over here, but I don't actually think it's going to be enough. A lot of those Marines taking pot shots.
Yeah.
Clyde has spread his tanks really well. He's got a nice concave against this small ramp here. The problem is BC Cutie's units and his tanks are all at full health. I mean, he's coming close to the point where he could think about stimming in.
Yeah, he certainly is. I mean, he's got plenty of tanks out across the map. If he kind of consolidated his forces, he might have the army to do that. He needs to be careful, though. Again, you know, TBT, very volatile matchup. One bad engagement that could change things, even if you are about 20 supply ahead, like we see Beastie Cutie is.
And here we go. Beastie Cutie is getting maxed out. He is really itching to move out at some point soon. Clyde, using that dead space between all of those sensor towers in the middle of the map to try and wait and see if his Marines can pick anything off. The problem is Beastie Cutie's being so careful with leapfrogging his tanks forward.
Yeah.
We have the tanks are always sieged up no matter where they are, and the Marines are never too far away. So Clyde is finding it very difficult to catch them off guard.
Oh,
he's
going
to try and do it now. The tanks do actually go down, and it looks like Clyde is finally going to be able to take
Not
an engagement
bad.
Off Beastie Cutie. That Marine concave was beautiful from the blue player.
He can't attack the planetary, though. That's kind of where this push kind of falls a little bit flat. He's going to be able to siege up outside, but does he have the tank count to really push this? I don't know, man. It's 14 tanks to 4. So Beastie Cutie, although he was a little bit out of position for that and lost some units, is still way ahead when
this
it comes to actual army.
This army is going to decide the game, Dora, I have a feeling.
I believe it certainly might. Yeah, there's not a lot Clyde can really do to stop it from killing one of his few remaining mining bases.
And Clyde now sees it on the mini-map as a lot of red dots over here, and he's going, well, hang on a second, I'm busy defending out in the middle. What can I do about it? It looks like he has to lift his third once again. Admittedly, it's almost mined out, but it's not something you want to have to be doing this late in the game.
Yeah.
And Beastie Cutie, look at this, sending his tanks back as well because he knows the army is about to be overrun and he doesn't want to lose those gas-intensive units.
Yep.
What a smart play coming out from Beastie Cutie.
Oh, yeah, he's playing awesome this game. I mean, he killed the command center. Marines are certainly disposable when you're on that many bases. And he's just kind of putting Clyde in yet another, you know, difficult spot and kind of exacerbating the hard position that Clyde is already in.
This is just excellent play. Beastie Cutie now mining, I would say, not quite double the minerals of his opponent, but mining all the gas at the moment.
Yeah.
Clyde actually isn't mining any gas, and to be fair, for good reason. He is actually sat on a bank of 1,800 at the moment.
Yeah.
He is very much mineral starved at this time. The problem is the siege tank count is still in Beastie Cutie's favor, 20-7, and he still has that Raven lurking around as well.
Wow.
But
we have
units caught on in the middle of the map. This is not something Clyde needs right now. He is behind in the siege tank count, and another two of them just got picked off.
Yeah, he just lost another tank with that. That hurts a lot. BC Cutie still very active with his Marines around the map right now. His defensive position outside of his fourth base was so brilliant. We hear Vespin Geyser being exhausted. Wouldn't be surprised, man. Ah, Sella. Not Sella. I said Sella because that's what his name looks like. Finally cleaning up some of these tanks.
Oh, and I like this decision from Clyde. I think he's now realized that Beastie Cutie is just hanging around as this command center on the left-hand side of the map goes down. Beastie Cutie counterattacking while he sees the main army of Clyde is going to be moving in. But the problem is Beastie Cutie has tanks dotted all around the map. GG. Oh, wow, that was amazing. At the end of that game, Clyde sort of clued into the fact there were only one or two tanks dotted around here and there from Beastie Cutie, so he went around and started killing them.
Yeah.
And Beastie Cutie was actually in real danger of losing a lot of his tank count just by doing that, but he seized the opportunity to counterattack, and the last mining base from Clyde went down.
Yeah, I mean, when you get to that point in the TVT where you're that far ahead, you know, base, two bases ahead, you only need a portion of your army to defend against their entire army, right?
Absolutely.
That really gives you a lot of leeway to then send those smaller squads around the map, picking off outlying bases, forcing your opponent to move move around. BC Cutie played that great, took an early lead, really made the best of it, and actually, you know, really outplayed Clyde, to be frankly honest with you.
That was really, really good. Very slow, very methodical. No impatience that we sometimes see Terrans get, of course, when they want to push out. Oh, let's unsiege in 1A because I have the tank advantage. Those are the kind of decisions you see that allow winning positions to become losing ones very quickly. We saw none of that
from Beastie Cutie.
Very slow, very methodical, and that's what grinds out the win. So that was a 40-minute game number one, but a really instructional one as far as TBT goes.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, any Terran player out there that really wants to play the Marine tank game in TBT, I really recommend you go back and study that game some more. Really good example of what to do, what not to do. Just great, solid, standard play from BC Cutie all around.
Very much so. So, guys, we're going to be going into game number two after a quick commercial break. I am Jarasar.
And I'm Doa.